Did you know that the very first assembly of photographs to create a motion picture was a 2-second clip of a black man on a horse?
Pause. Hold on. I mean, that's totally true, but what exactly is it doing? Let's look again.
Did you know that the very first assembly of photographs to create a motion picture was a 2-second clip of a black man on a horse?
Let's see, 4x3, black and white, 24 FPS. Wait, FPS, let's elaborate on that. By definition, FPS means frames per second. 24 pictures are frames to a second, hence 24 FPS. See, each one's a different individual picture. That word FPS comes all the way back from when, well, films were still shot on film. Each cell's a picture, and each picture needs a frame, hence 24 FPS. But what does this have to do with apparatus theory? In short, apparatus theory is, by its own definition, all about lying.
I can't lie!
Well, in a way, Mr. Curie, you are. Let's flash back a second. Does that look like motion to you? I thought not. In fact, it looks like tiny little pictures. Therefore, movement is simply an illusion of the eyes, according to the theory. Now, this fact is just as true with digital filmmaking as it is with actual filmmaking. But I bet you're wondering, why did we switch from film to digital? It's for a few reasons, but I think Sam Jackson puts it best when he says,
"That millimeter nitrate film was so flammable that you couldn't even bring a reel onto a streetcar."
Hey, you can't bring those there in a public vehicle. They're films, ain't they?
Yes.
Then they're flammable. Going off of...
Because nitrate film burns 3 times faster than paper.
Also, with filmmaking, we couldn't quite do stuff like this.
Hey!
Now, in apparatus theory, which is an offshoot of Marxist theory in the way it mentions belief and the way movies can influence them, it states that cinema is in of itself an ideological vehicle, an identification machine, for lack of a better word, forcing you to situate yourself within the way the director views the character. The director, by putting the picture on the screen, controls our perspective with every shot. This way, every time our eyes move and naturally spiral outward, the frame acts as a pseudo-director, telling you
what to do, what to think, and what to feel.
And, well, you subconsciously oblige. I mean, you've been doing it for years. A little macabre, I know, but hey, I mean, it's true. Tell me you've never seen a movie and been like, wow, I never knew that about them, and then it makes you see that person in a whole new light, even though it's completely false? Freddie Mercury, for instance, wouldn't know he was dying for another 2 years, lying at its finest in apparatus theory in action. Although cinema doesn't always tell the truth, the thing is, why Jean-Louis Baudry, the inventor of the theory, inherently views this as a negative? Isn't that half the fun? In fact, I view cinema as an experience, something to behold, whether it be together... We're all alone.
Whoa, whoa. Here I come.
Oh,
here I come.
Oh.
Mm. What's the trouble, Corporal?
There's a truck tailing us, sir.
I might be a farmer in a hurry to get someplace.
Something that can move us?
Finished second in school. This girl is still giving me C's, so... pulled me down, but you know, second's not bad. Grandpa attended the ceremony. I met another girl, Dad.
Or something that can take us on a journey far, far away from home. In all, cinema can be an ideological device, but why limit it? Why can't it simply be more?